Hello, I will present now a metamaterial made supercapacitor that harvests nuclear particle kinetic energy and delivers it as electricity as a new development in engineered nano-micro materials that improves the nuclear power production. And if that happens in my nano heterostructure, we call it CICI or GC, where a particle is passing through and produce a lot of recoil energy, we'll end up with removing all the thermomechanoelectric cycle, having the nuclear reactor that generates directly electricity. And you know, it's very important because nuclear power is by 6 orders of magnitude more compact than any other chemical power source. Though the power sources are more compact, are smaller, and give a million times more energy. Here is how the process takes place. When particles come into a layer that have a lot of available electron, it creates a large shower that flies ballistically through an insulator, say Teflon, and then is stopped into another element, the conductor one, maybe aluminium, and here it creates a negative charge, while the layer where the electron left, it becomes positive. And if you measure the materials, you'll see that elements like gold, uranium, have good electron availability and are good for one layer. The others are good for collecting layer, and some are good for insulator. And here is how the knock-on electrons are creating electron shower in the first layer and are ballistically tunneling the insulator and are stopping in the third layer in a simulation Monte Carlo code. Here is how it happens. A fission product goes along the layers and produce big showers in the high electron availability layer, producing a voltage and a current, and that is collected in as a conductive layer and put into a load resistor. From the point of view of material capabilities, it's huge. We can put on a material on a cubic millimeter about 5 kW per cubic millimeter, even more if we have a superconductive structure. But the devil is in the details because conversion efficiency matters, and each constructive solution has its efficient maximum efficiency. So this is a spherical beaded structure that efficiency may go up to 90% or more, and this is a planar structure where the conductive layers are connected in parallel like a parallel capacitor, and that has a 60% limit in maximum efficiency due to the solid angle. And this is a planar connected in series, and various evolutions from this planar to embedded nanobeads, the gold nanobeads suspended in silica, and advanced solution using nanotubes with longitudinal conductivity and transversal non-conductivity embedded into a lithium hydride, combining the effect of a high energy generator with low energy collector. There are many applications in space, like MORS antennas for remote ion beam teleportation, shielding, and for cosmic particles with energy conversion. The most near application is to make radiation batteries, included in alpha and beta voltaic, making foils that will be about 50 microns thick. This is a half, and here is the fuel, the plutonium-238 or polonium-210 that generates alpha particles that produce electricity. Here is how the power density is varying with the type of isotope we are using. We may use alpha and beta successfully, but no gamma because they have very low stopping power, and even they have a good density like cobalt 60, the dimensions will be huge for the battery, and instead of having a microfoil end up in centimeter. This is the powers for a plutonium 238 and polonium 210, and these are the minimum dimension for a battery, and that has the power for the minimum dimension. So if we turn them towards the center back into the nuclear reactor, we increase criticality, but if we leave them go away, we may decrease the criticality and we increase the transmutation production. And we may use nanoswitches that have response time in microseconds, controlling the reactor and using the probe neutrons. And this is some application we can do that. And these are various type of shielding with a classical called mass attenuation, because no matter what material you put for getting some attenuation level, you'll end up with about the same mass. Most Bauer-like quantum scattering that turns directed energy into 4 pi quasi energy, reducing the intensity on one direction, and quantum absorption and re-emission that is doing this effect. On the other side, we can use body shielding and electronic shielding to avoid electronic upset in radiation fields, and we can build a solid-state nuclear reactor, no moving parts, and only the electronics will control the criticality versus the absorption of the neutron. So all the neutron balance and the neutron economy will be electronically controlled. And that will make the reactor smaller, being able to be put on even SUV. This is what we are talking about, and that will be possible to be achieved after using all these five families of nanostructure in a synergistic way in order to have a fission battery. That will be smaller, will reduce the full power plant of today into a trailer, and will allow us having a lot of fancy application, that's flying spaceport, autonomy of more than several years for strategic airplanes, subways, and trains powered directly with energy. We can stop wars because we may use as power supplies for directed energy devices in outer space, able to shoot down even on terrestrial and deny even the cannon, the projectiles. Well, these are the materials that may trigger the leap and depend on us of how we see the future. We are looking to what remains after the actual nuclear power plant of monuments of a failed technology, and end up with a lot of capability of self-destruction, or you'll end up learning how to use plutonium and fission fissile materials in the same way we use gasoline today, making flying vehicles, propulsion, stop the wars, and focusing on the important stuff, colonizing our solar system and having a better planet. Now, as Albert Einstein and Niels Bohr once talked about and thought, any fool can know. The problem is to understand, and if we understand and we have a new knowledge, we'll have a lot of new questions we need to answer and understand even more.